Okay, we're going to do a quick demonstration now of the coffee temperature in the cup from the robot, because last time we did the demonstration we measured just when it comes out of the basket. A few people mentioned they want to see the whole thing, temperature in the cup. So what we're going to do, quick comparison with the Lamazoka Linea. And again, someone asked about back-to-back shots, how difficult or how easy it is. So we'll do a shot on that, measure the in-cup temperature, and then we'll do two on the robot just to show you, you know, how quickly you can do a back-to-back shot. So Lamazoka Linea, oh, first of all, so this is my, so we're using the professional basket for the, you know, fresh ground coffee. So again, this is room temperature, okay? So it's 32, today's very hot. So all I normally do is, so I get a cup, and just add a splash of water, and this is our cup as well. So we'll just preheat that. That boiled a few minutes ago, okay? So, just to show you on the scales, so the Linea set up about 92. Yeah, there you go. So you can see it's about 91. Yeah, 92 degrees. Okay. Right, so that one's set. I've got my beans ready. So we're not going to worry too much about the shot quality, we're just going to measure the temperature in the cup. So this has been preheated as well on the machine, just like you do, you know, in a shop or at home. So, give me a little pat. Right, preheated cup, it's quite warm, no pre-infusion. All we're going to do is measure the in-cup temperature. Okay. Stale coffee. Okay. Right, so there's our shot from the Lamazoka. We'll just measure what it is in the cup. So we have a stir. So what have we got? 68. What have we got? 67-ish? 67. 60. Yeah, so it's about 67 degrees C. In the cup, preheated cup. Right. So now we'll pull a shot on the robot and we'll check the temperature. So these have been just in the hot water now for, well, whenever that was, a minute, 2 minutes. There you go. Give it a wipe. Now, put our coffee beans in. So, all of the doses are the same, 14.5 grams. So we'll give a quick whisk, break up any clumps, get my little tamper, just a little tamp, pop the screen on, reboil the kettle now. So I'll get my dose ready for the next shot, second while the kettle boils. So the cup as well, that was preheated. We'll get rid of that. Okay, kettle just boiled, you heard the click. So fill it up to, there you go, 0.5 cm or so. Okay. I've no idea what this coffee's like. It seems quite stale, but it's the same. Right setting as that. That was the Lamazoka Linea burping. Yeah. Okay, pre-infusion. extraction, 7 bar, 6. So I'll try and let it tail off now. Pretend we're doing a lever. There we go. Okay, that's good enough. We'll stop the shot there. Stir. Same as we did on the Lamazotti. There's a temperature. What have we got? Oh. Okay, that's a bit hotter than the Lamazocco, 74. Okay, but it's just proving that the... I'm trying to support the Lamazocco here. So, 74, 73. So you can see it's still hot when it gets into the cup. So you can't really draw much comparison between the two. Still trying to be fair to Lamazocco. Okay, so as you can see, it's still hot when it reaches the cup. So what we'll do then, we need to remove all of the water. Yeah, you can see this, whenever you lift it up and push it down again, the puck gets all disturbed and it's pretty bad. Okay, that's why you should never pump the arms. Right, so you hear the sound. There we go. Get my nut box. There we go. Nice and clean. So what you could do, is what I'm going to do now. Bit of water down the sink. Okay, dry basket. Now we're back to the beginning. Line the beans again. Fluff up the grinds, break up any lumps, tamper again, make sure it's dry. Okay, so this is a very precision fit, which is why we've got a very thin base. The older one here is very thick and it created some suction. Okay, reboil the kettle, put our disc on. Okay, ooh, didn't preheat the cup. Okay. Kettle boiled. Add the water. Here we go. Okay, this cup wasn't preheated. My mistake. Oh, pre-infusion. Just gonna hold it there. What's that? 6. 7. Okay, lost it a bit there. There we go. So obviously I rushed that second shot, but it's just to show you the workflow, and that to do one shot, two shot, three shot, it makes absolutely no difference whatsoever. The cleanup is extremely easy. So just for fun, we'll get rid of this. There, again, you see that? Whenever you lift the levers up, it really disturbs the puck. That's why you shouldn't do that. Clean up again, take out the disc. Look at that. Exactly like a professional machine. And there you go, ready for another coffee.